Without seeking outside assistance, let us help you in determining the root cause of the car won't start unless I give it gas issue. Nothing is more inconvenient than a car that does not start at the start of the day. However, if it starts when you press the gas pedal, you may breathe a sigh of relief. But this does not mean that the problem has been solved. Indeed, it points to a problem in your car that requires immediate attention. Clogged air filter. Typically, the car air filter is in charge of cleaning and filtering the air that enters the engine as well as serving the ignition process. Debris and hardcore dirt can easily accumulate on the path connecting the air and the engine area if this component is not present. This accumulation is one of the most common causes of a car stalling unless you give it gas. Dirty fuel filter. A dirty fuel filter is one of the components that can cause the car to not start unless you give it gas. As one of the most important parts of the fuel line, it must be serviced on a regular basis. Many hidden problems will arise and worsen the engine's performance if the fuel filter is not cleaned or inspected on a regular basis. Failure to replace the gasoline filter on time may result in deposits within, eventually resulting in a blockage. Faulty fuel pump. This type of pump transports fuel from the gas tank to the engine to aid in the combustion process. Previously, these pumps were mechanically operated, but now, with a few exceptions, all automotive gasoline pumps are electric. Pumping is done by a tiny electric motor housed in a sealed enclosure. This electric motor wears out over time due to a variety of factors, and the fuel supply to the engine is cut off. Most electric pumps are housed in gas tanks and are cooled by gasoline. Compression errors. The car engine, like everything else, has a lifespan. When the engine's life is up, compression starts to fail, the engine starts to burn oil, and the car finally cranks but does not start, resulting in the car won't start unless you give it gas issue. The simplest solution is to visit a reputable mechanic who will use a specialized tool to evaluate cylinder compression. Aside from that, the expert will be able to tell you whether the engine is worth repairing. Failed mass air flow sensor. The mass air flow sensor monitors the amount of air that enters the intake. It sits between the air filter and the throttle body to control the airflow. If you're wondering why you have to press the gas pedal to start your car, the MAF sensor could be to blame. When this mechanism fails, the engine is forced to operate with an insufficient air-to-fuel ratio. As a result, the ECM fails to calculate the correct gasoline supply, making it difficult to start your car unless you give it gas. Swollen car throttle body. Modern fuel-injected vehicles have an intake system that uses the throttle to control airflow in the engine. The throttle is also required to start the engine. Unfortunately, dirt buildup will clog the throttle body, restricting engine airflow. Over time, the obstruction will reduce your vehicle's performance. How to fix? Here is a summary of the methods you can use to diagnose and repair your car when it won't start until you give it gas. Inspect fuel filter. You can visually inspect the fuel filter here. Certain filters have a window that allows you to look inside them. Replace the filters immediately if the view is dark, clogged, or dirty. However, some fuel filters do not have windows. In such cases, examine the outside condition of the filter, and if it has been there for a long time or appears rusted, consider replacing it. Check air filter. To allow enough air into the cylinders, it's always a good idea to check the air filter because it's a common cause of poor airflow. Check for any leaks or cracks in the air induction system that may be allowing excess air to enter the system if the filters are clean. You can do this by spraying starting fluid near the suspected area. If the engine's tune changes, it's a sure sign of leakage. Examine compression. Rent or buy a compression tester to check the compression and hopefully solve the issue. Turn on the engine and insert the compression tester's fitting into the spark plug. Unplug the ignition coil and fuel pump relay during the test. If the pressure difference between two adjacent cylinders is 40 psi, this is a serious problem. The compression value should ideally be greater than 100 psi. If you don't have a compression tester, place your finger over the spark plug hole. Then, request that someone start the engine. If your finger can withstand the pressure, your car's compression is insufficient. Inspect fuel pump. An amp clamp is placed over the positive pump wire to diagnose the fuel pump. Start the car and use a voltmeter to set and record the amperage reading. The recorded readings should then be compared to the manufacturer's specification. A high amperage reading indicates that the fuel pump is working harder, indicating that the pump needs to be replaced. The ultimate solution to the car won't start unless you give it gas. Test throttle body. Insert the alligator clips into the appropriate DMM jacks and set the range to 20k ohm. Attach the test lead to the center wire and the other lead to the ground connector or +12V input wire with three wires connected to the throttle body. Now, gradually move the throttle all the way from closed to fully open. If the digital reading suddenly increases or decreases, this indicates a faulty throttle position sensor. As a result, if you have any doubts that your car will not start unless you give it gas, try testing all of these components. Check the mass air flow sensor. Pollutants passing through the air filter may cause the MAF to fail. As a result, you must clean it first to determine if that is the issue. Because this component is delicate, only use specialized cleaners for this task. If cleaning fails, the MAF sensor should be reset. If the problem persists, replace the old MAF with a new one. This replacement procedure is quite challenging. You must carefully follow the instructions in the manual or hire a professional to do it for you. Regular maintenance is always required, and if done correctly, your car will have the confidence to deal with any issue that arises in the future. Hope the information was helpful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.